Hello students, today we will discuss our new topic, which is genetic recombination in case of prokaryotes. So before starting, we should know what exactly the genetic recombination is. Genetic recombination, we can say it is the exchange of genes between two DNA molecules, and a new combination of genes, or we can say a new recombination, is formed on chromosome. It is a type of recombination in which nucleotide sequences are exchanged between two similar identical molecules of DNA, or we can say where the homology is shown between DNA molecules, only that at that position the recombination is possible, and such situation is known as DNA genetic recombination. So there are two modes for transferring the DNA. One is vertical gene transfer and another one is horizontal gene transfer. So this diagram is showing the vertical gene transfer, and in this vertical gene transfer, the genetic information is transferred from parents to offsprings, and the DNA is transferred from this cell to these two cells. In case of horizontal gene transfer, the DNA is transferred in different transferred from microbe to another, or different strains or species of bacteria and viruses, and recombination is formed. So the horizontal gene transfer is basically of various types, like transduction, conjugation and transformation. So these are the three types, which is transformation, transduction and conjugation. So first of all, we will start with transformation. The transformation was first discovered by Frederick Griffith in 1928 in pneumonia. It involves the uptake of naked DNA molecules, which are released from one bacterial cell, and they are taken up by the another bacterial cell. So this is the experiment which shows, which was of Griffith, which shows that there is some genetic material. So in this particular experiment, Griffith took heat killed pathogenic strain of pneumonia, then live pathogenic strain of pneumonia, live non-pathogenic strain of pneumonia, and mixture of heat killed pathogenic and live non-pathogenic strains of pneumonia. So when heat killed pathogenic strain was transferred into the mice, then mice was live. When live pathogenic strain was transferred, the mice died. When live non-pathogenic strain was transferred, the mice was again living. But when the mixture of heat-killed pathogenic and live pathogenic strains were transferred, then the mice died and their blood contains live pathogenic strains of S. pneumoniae. So after that, we should know what is the factor competency and what are competent cells. So competency, we can say it is the ability of bacterium to take up DNA from the environment, and those cells which have this capability or which can be transformed are known as competent cells. E. coli can't go on transformation. It could be made competent by artificial transformation procedure, by calcium chloride or electroporation processes. Later on, what is the mechanism of transformation? The transformation mechanism we will show in this particular slide. These are the fragments of DNA from donor cells, and this cell is the recipient cell, and it is the chromosome of this recipient cell. The recipient cell takes up donor DNA. This is the donor DNA. It is taken up by the recipient cell. This is the recipient cell, and this is the donor DNA. Now the recombination occurs between donor DNA and the recipient DNA. This is the recombined form, and this unrecombined DNA is degraded. So in the step one, the DNA binding receptor on the competent cells bind double-stranded DNA. As the DNA entered cells, one strand is degraded and the other strand coated with single-stranded DNA binding protein. This single-stranded DNA binding protein has the ability to bind to the DNA, recipient cell. The single strand of DNA is integrated into the chromosome, and a transformed or recombined DNA is formed. Then another process is conjugation, which was described by Joshua Lederberg and Edward Tatum in 1946. It is a transfer of genes between cells that are in physical contact with one another. So physical contact is required for transferring genes or exchange of genetic material between two cells. It was found that traits could be transferred among two different strains of E. coli if they are in physical contact with each other. So for a conjugation, a physical contact between the two strains of E. coli is required. Then we should know what are F plus and F minus factors. It was described by William Hayes and Francis Jacob and Ellie H. That conjugating bacteria are two mating types. Male cells which donate their DNA, these are called F plus cells, and those cells which are lacking DNA and which are receiving, or female types, are called F negative cells, and these F plus and F minus are called fertility factor or sex factor. So this is the process of bacterial conjugation. This is the F plasmid, this is conjugation pilus, and this is chromosome. This is F plus cell, this is F minus cell. Now the donor attaches to recipient with pilus. This pilus is, you can say, conjugation bridge. The pilus draws the cells together. Then the cells are in contact with each other. The one strand of plasmid DNA is transferred to the recipient. This is the transfer. The recipient synthesizes a complementary strand to become F plus cells. And the donor synthesizes a complementary strand and restoring its complete plasmid. Then another important process is transduction. It is the phenomenon by which bacterial DNA is transferred from one cell to another with the help of bacteriophage. And bacteriophage are the viruses which infects bacteria. The process of transduction was initially described by Norton Zinder and Joshua Lederberg at the University of Wisconsin in 1952. Then this is the diagram showing the process of transduction. This is bacteriophage, and this is the host bacterial cell which is to be infected, and this is bacterial chromosome. Now phage inserts its DNA. Now this is phage DNA. Phage enzyme degrades host DNA. This is the degraded host DNA. Now cell synthesizes new phage that becomes incorporate phage DNA and mistakenly same host DNA. So these this is phage with donor DNA. Now this is transducing phage, and this is the recipient cell. Now it infects another bacteria, and in this way that this genome, or you can say bacterial genome part, is transferred to this new bacterium. Now donor DNA is incorporated into recipient's chromosome by recombination, or we can say this bacteriophage is working as a carrier for transferring this bacterial DNA to this. This is the donor one and this is the recipient one. Now transduction is of two types: generalized transduction and specialized transduction. The mechanism for comparing the bacterial genetic recombination, there are three mechanisms: conjugation, transformation, and transduction. In case of conjugation, physical contact, sex pili, and plasmid are required. The state of donor is living and the state of recipient is also living. In case of transformation, free DNA is required. Donor is dead and the recipient is living. In case of transduction, bacteriophage is required. The donor is killed by the bacteriophage and recipient is living.